In this episode of Real Chemistry, we're going to talk about stoichiometry again, and we're going to do some practice problems. So if you haven't yet watched my video, Introduction to Stoichiometry, I recommend you start there. In this video, we're just going to go through a few more practice problems so you can get a better hang of stoichiometry. Stoichiometry is basically just thinking about our chemical reactions as recipes. Just like this recipe below is a recipe for cheese sandwiches, we can have chemical recipes. And we can think about how much of different ingredients we need to put in to get out a certain amount of product. So let's go ahead and take a look at our first stoichiometry problem. This problem says 17.35 grams of aluminum react with excess oxygen. How many moles of aluminum oxide are formed? So here we have aluminum, the metal, combining with oxygen to form aluminum oxide. And we know that we're starting out with 17.35 grams of aluminum. And we know we don't need to worry about how much oxygen is around. It says there's excess oxygen, which basically just means our oxygen's not gonna run out. And we wanna know how many moles of aluminum oxide are formed. So we're gonna start with our quantity of aluminum. 17.35 grams of aluminum. And you'll notice that is our very first step for writing out our stoichiometry problems. We want to write out just our starting quantity. And we're always going to convert to moles. So if we don't have moles initially, we're going to convert to moles because our chemical recipe, our reaction up there, is in terms of moles, not in terms of grams. So we can't use grams. And the way we convert from grams to moles is with the molar mass of our aluminum. And so here the molar mass of aluminum is 26.98 grams per mole. So our 26.98 grams goes on the bottom, and our one mole goes up top. And that's just gonna give us moles of aluminum. And now we wanna go to moles of aluminum oxide. So the way we do that is we write out over on the right-hand side just that desired quantity, and that's gonna help us write our conversion factor. So we know that we wanna get to, at this point, moles of aluminum oxide. Moles of Al2O3. And so now we're going to write our conversion factor using our chemical recipe. And we know that we want to get rid of our aluminum. So we want to have moles aluminum down here. And we know that we want to get to aluminum oxide. So we're going to put moles Al2O3 up here. And then the numbers we fill in there come from our chemical recipe. So we see that there's a 2 right here in front of our aluminum oxide. And so that's the number we put in for our conversion factor. Every time we run this recipe, we get 2 moles of aluminum oxide out. And to run the recipe, we know we need to put 4 moles of aluminum in. So since there's that 4 next to aluminum, that's what we put in our conversion factor down here. We plug all of that into our calculator, and we'll get out 0.3215 moles of aluminum. So what we did there is we used our reaction to figure out how much aluminum oxide we could get out, given 17.35 grams of aluminum going in. Let's take a look at our next stoichiometry problem. So here, we're reacting oxygen with excess hydrogen to get out the grams of water formed. And so here, we have another step to add. In the past problems, we were going from grams to moles, and our final answer was gonna be in moles. In this case, we want our final answers in grams. And that tacks one more step onto our stoichiometry problem, where we have to convert from the moles of product we form to the grams of product we form. So once again, we're gonna start the same way. We're gonna start by writing out our starting quantity, which is 1.45 grams of oxygen. So we have 1.45 grams of O2. And so that's step one. And then we wanna convert that to moles. So we wrote our starting quantity, and now we're gonna convert to moles. And oxygen has a molar mass of 32 grams per mole. So we're going to convert now from grams of oxygen to moles by writing 32 grams on the bottom and one mole up top. So that's going to get us to moles of oxygen. Our grams are going to cancel there, and we're going to have moles of oxygen. And we know that eventually we want to get to, way out here, grams of H2O. So we write our starting quantity, and it's nice to write our desired quantity, I'm sorry, because that just gives us an idea of where we're going, and that helps us know what steps to take next. So we want to eventually get to grams of water. So before we can do that, we need to get to moles of water, and that's where we're going to use our stoichiometry conversion factor. So here we're going from oxygen to water. So we're going to cancel out our oxygen, and we're going to get our H2O. Doesn't really matter in these conversion factors if you write out mole explicitly or not. These are just ratios that work in terms of moles, and you can go ahead and drop the moles if you want, or write it out if that helps you keep track. So next to our oxygen, we're going to write 1, because that is the number in front of oxygen in our chemical reaction. There's nothing actually written there. There's just an implied 1. And then we look over at water, and we see a 2. So that's going to get us to moles of water. And since what we want is grams of water, then we know that we need to convert to grams. So we wrote our conversion factor using the recipe, and now we need to convert to grams of water. So when we're dealing with moles of water, to convert to grams of water, we know we need to use the molar mass of water. And here it's really important to keep track of what you're actually converting. So in the past, you might have just been able to keep up with, okay, I'm converting moles to grams or grams to moles. Now you need to actually think about, I'm converting from moles of water to grams of water, which is different than what we were doing in the start of problem, which was grams of oxygen to moles of oxygen. And what we're converting tells us what molar mass to use. So we're going to need to use here our molar mass of water, because that's what we're left with at this point. Our oxygen has been canceled out. And since we're left with water, we need to use the molar mass of water. And the molar mass of water is 18.02 grams. So we're going to put 18.02 grams up here and 1 mole down there, because currently you'll notice we have moles. And if we write moles on the bottom, that's going to let that cancel out, and we're going to be left with grams. Now, I write that all into my calculator, and I'm going to get 1.63 grams of water. So that is our final answer. This stoichiometry problem was just a touch more complicated than the last one. We went to moles first, and then we had to convert all the way to grams of our product. So these chemical recipes allow us to think about how much mass of something we could put in and how much mass of something we would get out. All right, our last stoichiometry problem is going in a little bit of a different direction. Here, we're actually given how much product we want to form. So it says how many moles of oxygen, which are a reactant, are needed to form 1.4 grams of aluminum oxide, which is a product. So we're going to go backwards. And this is totally fine. It's just like if I walked into the kitchen and I saw 10 grilled cheeses made, and somebody said, how much bread did they use? Well, they used 20 slices of bread. And the same way, we can say we want 1.4 grams of aluminum oxide, so how much oxygen do we need to put in? And what we're still going to do is we're still just going to write out our starting quantity, which is 1.4 grams of aluminum oxide. And since our chemical recipes only work in terms of moles, we're going to go ahead and convert to moles. And to convert our grams of aluminum oxide to moles, we need to use the molar mass of aluminum oxide, and that turns out to be 101.96. So we put 101.96 down here. And that's grams in 1 mole up top. Now, I've already calculated the molar mass of aluminum oxide so that we can do this problem a little more quickly, but sometimes you'll actually have to calculate those molar masses as you go through. So now we're left with moles of aluminum oxide. Our grams, they've gone away. And now we're gonna want to use our chemical recipe to write our conversion factor. And to know what conversion factor to write, we're gonna go ahead and write down our desired quantity. And we know that we wanna get moles of oxygen. So we want to get moles of oxygen, and we want to get rid of moles of aluminum oxide, which means aluminum oxide is going to go down on the bottom, Al2O3, and oxygen is going to go up top. And then we just look at the recipe. It doesn't matter whether we're going forwards or backwards. The recipe tells us what conversion factors we need to use. And notice that there's a 2 in front of our aluminum oxide, and so we're going to put a 2 down here. And there's a 3 in front of our oxygen, so we're going to put a 3 in front of our oxygen in our conversion factor. Because our chemical recipe just tells us the ratio of stuff we put in and get out. And we can use that to calculate how much stuff we'll get in, we need to put in, or how much stuff we'll get out. And so now notice we're going to get rid of our moles of aluminum oxide, and we're going to be left with just oxygen. So our Al2O3s, they go away, and we're left with just moles and oxygen. And when I plug that into my calculator, I'm going to get 0.021 moles of oxygen. So notice now, if the question had asked for grams of oxygen, we could do that too. All that we'd have to do now is just multiply our 0.021 moles of oxygen by the molar mass of oxygen. So all sorts of different questions we can ask involving stoichiometry problems. But hopefully now you have a good handle on how to write the correct conversion factors down to answer a wide range of stoichiometry problems. Thanks for watching this episode of Real Chemistry. If you have any questions, please leave them below. And as always, I suggest that you subscribe to my channel so you can get updates about future videos.